Nobody likes getting old, but what exactly makes us age? One hypothesis is that aging is caused by immunosenescence. As we get older, our immune system becomes less effective, allowing microbes to overgrow and cause disease. Exceptionally long-lived mammals, such as blind mole rats, seem protected from both immunosenescence and aging. Is there similar evidence in humans? AIDS is caused by a virus which kills a specific type of immune marine cell, the signals officer, or SIGs. Unlike other marines, SIGs are unarmed and don't kill microbes themselves, but having too few SIGs results in uncoordinated immune responses. This allows normally well-tolerated microbes to overgrow and kill AIDS patients, so aging might be like dying of AIDS in slow motion, as SIGs gradually become less effective. Syphilis offers a specific example of this process. Most syphilis symptoms occur shortly after infection, as treponema spreads throughout the body. Another set of symptoms, known as tertiary syphilis, take decades to materialize and mainly affect the elderly. Why such a long delay? After all, affected organs had been colonized by treponema for many years without symptoms. In the 80s, it was realized that AIDS patients develop tertiary syphilis at a very young age. This suggests tertiary syphilis is triggered by a weakening immune response as SIGs become less effective at combating treponema. What if the same occurred with Malassezia? Seborrheic dermatitis is a severe type of dandruff caused by Malassezia, which mainly affects the elderly. Yet it bears no evidence of a strong immune response against Malassezia. Instead, it looks like our Marines have surrendered. The only good proof of Malassezia's involvement is that antifungals are very effective. Parkinson's disease is strongly associated with seborrheic dermatitis, and both are excessively common in young AIDS patients. Because AIDS precipitates these diseases, we suspect SIGs' failure to protect us from Malassezia are their root cause. Malassezia require lipids to grow, which is unusual. Most fungi have a sweet tooth. Abundant lipids increase seborrheic dermatitis and Parkinson's risk, perhaps by feeding Malassezia. Unfortunately, this evidence is insufficient for a jury of scientists to convict Malassezia for Parkinson's. Heck, even seborrheic dermatitis jury had a few holdouts. Proving Malassezia's role in Parkinson's is a daunting task. It's almost the perfect crime. And it's not just Parkinson's. Alzheimer's and atherosclerosis, two common diseases of aging also linked to lipids, might be the Malassezia equivalent of neurosyphilis and syphilitic aortitis. As occurred with seborrheic dermatitis, proof could be limited to the efficacy of antifungal drugs. If you know of strong evidence or experiments that can link Malassezia to diseases of aging, please share them with us by clicking here.